So we were discussing about customization and shortcut, and we had left the session after this popular option. Okay. So next option we have formulas. So in formulas, there are some options related to formulas. Any numbers and the rand between formula you might have seen. So when I was doing calculation, it was getting refreshed all the time. Let's suppose I have typed here some data and put a sum formula in this D5. So if I change the value, any of the above value, that sum formula change. Okay. Basically, it is happening because of calculation options. When I enter any of the value, the calculation happens here. Okay. Now, Excel automatically calculates the thing. So there are two modes for calculation. One is automatic and second is manual. You can find these options in formula tab also. In calculation options, you have three options: automatic, automatic except for data table, and manual. By default, our calculation options are set to automatic. But if we set it to manual, then what happened? If I change any of the data, it will not show me the immediate calculation under formula. For seeing the calculation, I need to press this calculate now button. Okay. When we do, let's suppose we have a sheet where we have lots of formulas, and the formulas take time to calculate the value. So when you have lot of formulas, it takes lot of time to calculate also. Because of that, your sheet become hang. Your Excel hangs there. So if you have large data, so just do your calculation and then use calculate now. Or by mistake, your calculation options are set to manual, you can choose automatic. So that if you change the value, it can directly give you the result. Okay. This option, in Excel option, you have formula tab. Here you have calculation options. These three types of calculation options are in here. Then the other option we have, enable iterative calculations. Iterative calculations, what are the iterative calculations? Let's suppose I type here 10, or I type a formula that in F4 you add 10. In downwards, in F4, I will type that in F3 you add 10. So this is called iteration, when the references are calling to one another, to each other. Okay. So it becomes a circular reference. It becomes a loop here. So when you enter, there is a circular reference warning. Means it is saying that how can it possible that you are adding values to downwards and you are putting the same formula that and upwards you plus the 10 again. So the formula, the references are entangled between each other. So this is called circular reference, iterative calculations. So if you want that iterative calculation, then you can enable it from here. Basically, you don't, you never use this option. This option, the mathematicians or scientists with more. So they can the iteration. The 50 times it should call the each other reference. When I press OK, so it will calculate the value for me. Basically, in GTA we do these things by group kind of thing. And if you know something about C, this method is called recursion. But you don't need to use it. I am just telling you that.
But what is the best value to set iterative calculation? What is the best value?
This iterative calculation is just about calling formula, calling references.
I know. I see you set at maximum. I put my own at 100. Is there a difference? When I'm doing a model, I put it at 100.
What? Okay, the maximum you are talking about?
Yes, I said, what's the a good value to put it? Is there, once you put it above 100, is it okay?
No, not 0 to 100. That, how many times it has to iterate. It is like this.
Okay.
Okay, if I type 100 times, if I type 100 times, it will call the 100 times that reference, that F3 will call F4 1 and F4 will call F3 2, like this. It will call and calculate the value, start from 0.
Okay.
It is like this, but you don't need this actually. I'm just telling that what are the iterative calculation. There is a concept about it, whole programming concept.
I know. I'm saying if you set the value at 100, so is there a problem? If you say enable iterative calculations at 100, is there a problem?
I have set it to 100 times. Maximum iterations I have set to 100 times.
Okay. Okay, no worries.
Then you have R1C1 reference style. Do you know what is it? What it is?
What is that?
R1C1 reference style. See,
yes, I know about reference system. Yes, I do.
So basically, it is about absolute referencing and relative referencing. What is absolute referencing? If I am typing a equal to and choosing the value of A1. This A1 value, if I call from anywhere, it will be A1 only. Means I have to refer it by A1 only. So it will link to this value. But if we change this to R1C1 reference, so what happens? Earlier for columns there was ABC, but now it is 1, 2, 3, 4 as well. See, when we choose equal to, like earlier we were choosing A1. So when we choose, so it is showing me R-1, C-4. Okay. This is basically the coordinate system, relative reference. Takes the relation from this cell and how far it is, that row minus 5, if we count here, this cell is 0, row 0, column 0. If we go downwards, like if I select any cell, so when I am on this cell, this is R0, C0, matlab row is in, column is in. And I am going down, so row 1, column 0. When I am moving to column, row 1, column 1, 2, 3, it counts the columns. And if you go to in reverse, it will minus it. 1, 2, 3, like that, it will set the reference. So this is called relative referencing. So this relative referencing we mostly use in DBA with offset. Because in VBA we don't know where is our data. We need to find our data with the program. So we set a like reference that you find first this value, move three columns ahead, down, move down. So that's how we select the data to VBA. So this is R1 single reference style. Then you have formula autocomplete. Suppose you are typing any formula, so you see a list of formula. If I type B, so the formula is starting with B, then we see here. So this is called autocomplete. When you press tab, this formula completes. So in formula autocomplete, if your formula, this list is not appearing, you can, it may be unchecked. Just uncheck from here. Then, when we type formula, we use table name in formula. Table. I will, do you know the concept of tables? In my further further sessions, I will tell you about tables. Let me show you. I have converted it to table. This table name is table 1. So I can refer it by table 1. This reference by name, we want Excel to take this reference by name or not. This option is about this table name in formula. Then sometimes we type, we have to type 0 before any number. So what we use this quotation mark. Quotation mark when we type 0 and we have to convert it to text, or we use quotation mark for typing 0 before, because if I am typing 0 like this, so it will not appear. After doing that, I think there is a error like green. There is a error symbol. If I press this button, so it shows me that what error number is stored as a text. There are few rules for it and color style for this type of errors. So there is a color set. One formula in error checking. You want to enable this background error checking or not? Right, green. And these are the rules.
Please speak louder, Sandeep. Sandeep, speak a little louder, please.
Okay. So, for checking background error, we have some settings here that we need to enable background checks. We need to select the color from here, like it is by default green. And some are the rules, earlier we are getting error by number formatted as text. So this rule is here, number formatted as text. See, and check this, it will never show the error on this type of. So here are some settings about it. Let's go to proofing. You know, while using this tool, spell checks, if I type any wrong thing, that I have hardly mistake here, but when I check When I do spell check, it is showing me that you have typed wrong and adjacent to the place. Okay. The spell check is complete. It is not showing this one. The letters in cap, the word in capital letters. If you want to check the errors in capital letters also, the spell check. So in proofing, here is one option, ignore words in upper case. It is already checked. That's why it is ignoring the upper case. But if you uncheck that, after pressing F7, you can see it is also highlighting now. It is considering the upper case also. Then sometimes what happens, we want to type like PM. Let us convert into some symbol when we type. I have removed some of them, that's why it is not. If I type in bracket PM and I press enter, it converts into trademark symbol. Likewise, if you type C in bracket, it will change into copyright sign, and that R will convert into registered sign, registered symbol. For copyright and register, it is not converting here because I have no way. So, if you don't want this conversion, so you need to disable the option from proofing, autocorrect option. And here you have option replace text as you type. Just off that, take it off. Uncheck. Okay. Okay. So when now I am able to type PM in brackets and it will not convert. It is actually the automatic conversion when you type. So we can, it is like a dictionary. We can add the letters of our choice also. Like for my name, like SK. If I type SK, it will be converted into English formula. I can add the things here. SK. Replace text as you type. I have checked that. Press OK. When I am typing, it is not converting. So it is changing now. So you can set some abbreviation for long words like your company name or department name or your name. Some initials you can set, and when you type that initial, it will automatically get you that full text. Now one more error occurs when we type, we are typing email like anything and email.com or web address. So as you can see, it is converting into hyperlinks. And if I have to edit this, I need to go with my keyboard. If I go with my mouse, it shows me to click, and accidentally if I click on that, it will open my Outlook, the main address. So I want to temporarily off this conversion, this hyperlink conversion. So in proofing autocorrect option, you have second tab, auto format at the type. So there you have option internet and network path with hyperlink. And press OK. Can you type the email address? Now let's move ahead of that. Whatever you were practicing here, just make it like it was earlier, because if you forget, it will trouble you. Then we have option save. See, when we are saving our workbooks, I want to do save as. It is getting me dialog box and it is on desktop. If you want to set its default that it should not be on desktop, it should be on D drive and some other folder, so you can set it. And you can set the save as type also, like it is selected Excel macro enabled workbook. It is already there because for VBA file, I need this format, Excel macro enabled workbook. If I forget to save in Excel macro enabled workbook, my VBA program will lost. So I have to set this saving default also. So this default I can set in actual options, save tab. So I can choose save file format from here, from the available formats. Then I can choose my default file location, which is this one, desktop. I need to copy paste the URL, like I want to save these files on into D drive in some folder like this. So I will copy from here and paste it here, then press OK. Okay. You have one another option, save auto recover information in every 10 minutes. If your computer accidentally shut down and you are working on any file of Excel more than 10 minutes, it gets saved here. And when you restart Excel, you can see the left side of your pane for recover the file. So this is the auto recover file location from where you can file your, you can find your files which has not been saved and accidentally closed. After 2007 version, in 2010 you can find those files also which you haven't saved but worked for 10 minutes, more than 10 minutes for temporarily on that location. Then if you are saving auto recover information in every 10 minutes, if you are using large file, it can be hanged, because some files take 10 minutes to save and after 10 minutes it is saving again, so your Excel will be hanged there. So you have a choice here, disable auto recover for this workbook only. If you open any large workbook, so you can choose this option and select the workbook from here and open any open workbook, so that the auto recover information for that particular file will be temporarily off. Then let's go to advanced tab. See, when we press enter on our keyboard, when we press enter on our keyboard, our mouse, this cursor goes down, which is its default behavior. But you can change this setting from in Excel option advanced tab. You can see the first option after pressing enter, move selection, the direction you can choose from there. There was down, right, up, left. So this setting is here. If you change that to up, when you press enter, it will go up. So everything, every default you can set here in advance. Then sometimes we work with decimal numbers. So in decimal numbers we have to put dot every time, like 12.32. I need to press this point. So we have an automatic conversion of this decimal here, just like you can see on some ATMs. In advanced setting option, automatically insert a decimal point. So if I type any value here, 1032, I have not typed decimal here, when I press enter, it will automatically insert decimal after 2 digits. So if you are dealing with decimals for temporary help, you can use it. Or if it is doing automatically, you can make it off from here. Then sometimes you want to drag something, like this black dot is there on your cursor. If you want to drag something, this black dot is here, and when you move your cursor, it converts into a black plus sign. So when you drag it, sometimes what happens, this black dot not appears. So the third option is about this. If it is unchecked, this black dot will not appear and you will not find any option to drag the value. So this can be repaired from there. In advance, the third option, enable fill handle and cell drag and drop. Okay. So you can drag it now, if this black dot is appearing. Let's go more further. Then rest of the small options are there. You just need to keep in mind there, for every setting we have options here. So you need to keep checking it. The important one I am telling you, such as grid line colors, show grid lines. If you want, if you don't see grid lines like this, so where to go? Otherwise these options are available in your ribbons also. You can make it from here. But grid line color is not there, it is only there in advance. So you can, if your grid line is not appearing as black, is appearing red, so you can restore it by going to Excel options, advanced tab. Then let's see something in customize. In customize, you have some, here you have quick access buttons. Some buttons already you have for quick access and some you can add there. These are some shortcuts which you usually use, like you use filters a lot and you are finding difficulty to find filter all the time. So you can set as default option there in customize. you have here, such as I have added here paste values, but you need to add filters here. So we can find from here tab to tab, like filters and sorting. There is filter. So I add this, I remove this paste values option. So now I can see the option for filter is here. When I press it, it will apply the filter. Okay. So we use some shortcuts here. Then in customize tab, in this quick access toolbar you can add macros also. From here you need to choose commands from the macros. If you are added some add-ins, so you can choose macro from here, and all the available macro will be listed out here, and you can add there as a button from other files. So I will tell you after, when we go get into this, I will tell you in details also each of the options. But for now I am just setting your mind that where we can find these options. Then we have add-in tab. In add-in we can add lot of add-ins. I have talked about add-ins. Now that you have to add some functionality, have some macros, so we prepare add-ins by saving our VBA code in XLA file. Excel add-in file, it is there. This option, this Excel add-in will save in with XLA format, and it will contain the VBA code only. So that VBA code, it contains macros, so we can find the macros there. And from add-in option, we will add the add-in. In manage, we have go, and we can browse any add-in here, and we can add it. Okay, after selecting this, so we can add add-ins, extra programming, programmability from these add-ins. Then we have the last, trust center. In trust center settings, we have some settings, some security settings like this, like message bar. When your macro is disabled, it shows you the message bar. So you want to show the message bar or not, you can select from here. Then you have macro setting here. You want to disable, enable the macro by default, so you can choose the settings from here. ActiveX. ActiveX controls are the buttons. The buttons, text box we use in Excel. So if it is not working fine, so you can check it from here. It should be enabled. And then external content. External content, sometimes we apply pivot table from outside Excel, like Access, SQL. From there if we apply, so we can manage. Here is the security setting for that. It should be enabled to use the outside data. That means external content. Okay. So likewise you have some settings for add-ins. So that's all about customization of Excel. Okay. Now let me tell you some number formatting in Excel. Earlier I told, I have showed you that format cell dialog box where we have number tab. So let me show you some examples that when we should use it and how to use it. So let us take some numbers here so that I can show you the differences of number bracket. I put some minus values also, value more than 1000. Then I select and click on this arrow option. That will also open this format cell option. So in number tab we have number formatting. By default it is general. That means Excel's automatic and number conversion. Then we have number. In number option we have decimal places, so that we can select that how much decimal places we need. Here it is 2. When we press it to OK, it will be 2 decimal places. Another option we have use separator with comma. So when we click on that, so it will put comma before any thousand number. So we can see that there is a comma. Then we have a column for negative numbers. By default our negative number, what it should be look like? By default it is with minus. And if I select the second option, it is red. So by default it is by minus. But if I select the red one and I press OK, so that negative sign will not be there, but the value will be in red. The negative value will be shown in red. In third option, it will not change the color, but it will put brackets before this negative numbers. So negative numbers will come in brackets. In fourth option, it will change the color and it will put brackets here. Okay. Then we have currency. In currency we have the decimal places just like number formatting, and we have symbols. So we can choose any currency sign here. If you are not finding your currency here, you can download the font from Google itself for the currency. So let us take as dollars, and the negative numbers are same. Okay. So we have applied currency to it. Then we have, after currency, we have accounting. In accounting, we have decimal places and symbols. No negative are there. So how it is different from currency? See, if I apply this dollar formatting here, see what happens. In this currency format, it is aligned. The currency is aligned here. But in currency format, it is not aligned. It is before the number. So banks use this type of formatting, this accounting format, to show the statements. And if you put zero there, so it will not show zero. It will show you a hyphen here. Here you can put zero. So this is the basic difference between currency and accounting format. Then we have dates. If you put some date, so basically it is a number. If we convert it to general, it will show me the number. Okay. Can anybody tell me that what is this number? What is it exactly? Ma'am, can you tell me what is this number? Hello. Hello. Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Can you tell me what is this number? Hello.
Number format.
No, what does it actually mean? This is a date. If I see this number, it will show me the date. But if I convert it to general format, it shows me the number. What is that number? You need to understand that before we proceed. That what is this number? I tell you what is this number. If I put 1 and I convert it to date format, it shows me a date here, 1st January 1900. So our date starts from there. If I type here 366, means after 1 year. We have 365 days. So, it was a leap year. Type here 367. So it will show me the date as 1st January 1901. That means these are the days from 1900 till now, how many days we have spent. Okay. So in general format, it shows you the date. Likewise, if we put here time, okay, if we convert it to general format, it shows you some decimal figures. But we have a function here, now, that gives you date and time. And if I convert it to general format, so it will give me the date before the decimal and the time after the decimal. So you see? So that's how it evaluates dates and time. When we talk about date and time formula, I will elaborate it more.
Now
is the formula for time. The date and time.
It will show like that.
You understand? Is it clear, ma'am?
Date and time.
Yes. Now returns date and time. As you can see here, it is date and time. Okay. This is the numeric value, the general value for this. So, let us be with format. So number. What is number format? Number formatting actually? It does not change your value. The reality of your values will be same. But the visibility of the value will be changed. Number formatting does not change its reality. It changes its visibility only. Okay. So this date and time always a number. Okay. So let us do with date format. That what are the options we have in date format, because Excel is calculating by itself. So we have definitely some options here. We can choose different time of date formats from here. Like that, I want to show that which day it is, and what is the date. I can choose this format. Here it will show me the day also, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday. Okay. Then we have 314. It is like it will show you the date and the month. In MD format. Then I have different format like abbreviated month name with year and 2 year, two decimal, two number, two digit of year. Then if I need 4 digit of year, I have a format for that. This is for 4 digit of year. When you want to show the month name and the year name only, you can choose this format. Okay. So as per your requirement, you can change the same date's visibility according to your format. Let's do with time. I've selected a time here and I go to the format. So in time format, what we have this 1330 format, that means 24 hours format. Okay. It is 24 hours format. It doesn't require AM and PM. Then we have the upper one, the 12 hours format. There it requires AM and PM. And if you want to know the time elapsed, means one worker gets into the office and returns after 3 days, so how many hours he spent in the office. So that type of format we can do by this 37 by 30 format. It is beyond 24 hour format.
Okay.
So it is not showing now because let us convert it to general and increase the value of it. It is general. I do it. I have told you that before decimal is day's value and 1 day is equal to 24 hours. So 24 hours and till 8 p.m. it is like, let's see what it is. How many hours are there? I just press control 1 in time. I choose this 37-30 format. It is 44 hours. Okay. So basically it is about 3 formats. Below 12 hours, below 24 hours and beyond 24 hours. Okay. So these 3 formats you have here. Then we have percentage. See, in percentage, when we type any value, it just it does not change the value of the value. When we select the percentage, so this 1 to 3 converts into 100, 200, 300%. But if I multiply to it with any of that, so it will multiply to its actual value, which is 1. Okay. So that means in actually it is 1 to 3. Okay. It just changed the visibility. You can't do calculation by seeing the value. It can be other. Okay. But if you are in this conversion, if you have converted the value, so when you are typing this, I am typing here 50, so that means 50%. The value will be, in general format, it is 0.5. Okay.
So
it gives you the typing flexibility here, but that doesn't mean it will change the value. The value will be same for that. Okay. Then we have fractions here. You know fractions, 1 by 2, 2 by 3, like this you have fractions. So we have here 2.5, and if I change it to fractions, the first one, so it will show you like this. to 1 by 2. That's how this fractional format. And then you have scientific, which we do not use. I told you last time that when we have to prefix some zero, like if we are typing check numbers, they do have zero most of the time. So we will type with quotation mark 0023 and the check number like this. So when we have to type zero, we every time have to fix that quotation. But I want to make it frequent that I don't want to type this quotation mark before. So what I will do, I will select the area and I will do make it to text format. I will select the text format and do OK. So when the selected cells now are in text format, as you can see here. So in text format, whatever you type will be text. You need not to type quotation mark before that. You can directly type. Okay. Even if you type any formula, so it will not going to calculate the value because it is text. It is like this. For making it real, you have to convert it general format F2. And then press enter, then it will work. It will goes to general format. Then we have special, which we will not use. Instead of that, we will use this custom. This custom formatting, I will tell you in Monday's session because tomorrow it's Holi here. So it's a festival, so we will be off there then. So I will send you the billing information. So demo class is over till now. From Monday we will continue from same time. Okay, the billing information will be sent to your mail. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
The recording will be sent to you on your email IDs.
Yeah.
So we'll meet on Monday. Okay. If you have some problem in depositing money, just let me know. So that we will be continuing in this session, in the further sessions also. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you for now.